What is good, friends? We are here with more Smoke on Snake Draft. This is a semifinals game between BTB and Tricking. So let's look at the teams real quick. I assume this is either a Z-move or a Specs. Coco, Mega Pinsir with Earthquake as the Frustration, Quick Attack, pretty standard. So the Lando and the Pharaoh could be the hazard setters. It could be Rocks, Lando with Spikes, Pharaoh, which means Heatran gets another move slot, which means it could be Taunt, Toxic, Earth Power, Magma Storm, Tren. And yeah, this is going to be a Scarf Lady with Healing Wish support. And the defensive Lando, because he's quite annoyed by Zygarde. He has a Pharaoh as well, but if the Pharaoh is Spidef to check Greninja, then Zygarde is a threat to his team for sure. So looking at Tricking's team, it's either Z-move Lele or Z-move Magnezone, but I assume the Magnezone might have to be Scarf. Otherwise, like, Pinsir is like a really big threat, and I don't think another one could be... Yeah, the Lele could also be Scarf, yeah. So it's Mega Sharpedo, usually runs Protect 3 attacks, most of the time doesn't even run Waterfall in OU because Psychic Fang's Crunch and Ice Fang just hits a lot. So we do see that the Lele is not Scarf because the Coco's terrain went first. So the Coco's either gonna Volt Switch or U-turn out into the Pharaoh or the Heatran here. So if I'm Tricking here, if I'm Specs, I would click Focus Blast. If I'm not Specs, if he's like a common variant, I would click Calm Mind. Let's talk about the rest of the team. Pinsir is gonna be amazing in this game, because Hawlucha can get Quick Attack even if Psychic Terrain is up, and it only gets a Spidef boost from the Psychic Seed. It does not get a Fizdef boost. So as long as BTB has his Pinsir and also Coco, he's gonna be able to deal with Hawlucha. I mean, sometimes they run Poison Jab to deal with Coco after some chip, but he has a Pinsir as well, so he's gonna be fine in that regard. The Lando's gonna have to be defensive on Tricking's team, and the Pex has to be Spidef. I'm thinking Black Sludge, Payapa, or Shedshell are all options on this Pex. Because the team is quite weak to Volcarona, so Payapa is definitely an option. And I don't think it's AV zone, because the Pex is going to be like super Spidef to deal with stuff like Greninja. So it's either Z-move or Scarf zone. But since the Lele wasn't Scarf, I'm thinking the zone is going to be the Scarfer. The Lando could also be Scarf, but then the team would be way too... Nah, the Lando cannot be Scarf. The team would be way too weak to Zygarde. So he Volt Switches out. We do see that his choice backs damage from the Coco. And he's now going to go into Ferrothorn, I assume. Since Tricking also has a Magnezone to trap the Ferrothorn, so yeah, going Ferrothorn is completely fine. So it's Calm Mind. So it's most likely Z-move. So either Shadow Psych or All Out Pummeling. So it's gonna go for the Z-move here. Let's see which one it is. Because, like, I don't really see what else would be the Z-move user on Tricking's team. Since this is not Scarf, like I said, the zone has to be Scarf. His other only speed control is Sharpedo getting Protects up, and Hawlucha having its seed up, but that only works once. Like, Hawlucha can only come in once with the seed and get its speed boost. I think that's how Burden works, I'm pretty sure, yeah. So he does go for the Z-move. Is it Pummeling? It's Shattered Psych. So the reason why he went for Shattered Psych over HP Fire was in case BTB went into his Heatran. BTB gets up a Spike, which is going to be amazing to chip at that Magnezone, and he's just going to be able to spam Return with his Pinsir. He doesn't even have to predict and click Earthquake. Now he goes for HP Fire, completely understandable. BTB can now go into his Pinsir here and just click Frustration. I mean, he could click Return trying to predict the Magnezone, but it's not necessary. I feel like this is just BDB's down 6-5-6, but like, he's in the, like, overall he has the matchup, he's like in a fine position. Like, he can just click Frustration or Return, and like, Lando's usually don't carry Stone Edge anymore, so like, Tricking's Lando is not able to check Pinsir that well. So like, if his Magnezone is not Scarf, what Tricking has to do is go Magnezone on Frustration and pivot into Landorus on an Earthquake. So yeah, BTB, let's just go for Return, doesn't do much. So now BTB should switch into Landorus, scouting for Scarf T-Bolt, and Tricking should go into his own Landorus, because going into his own Landorus for Tricking covers BTB going into his Landorus, kind of, and it covers BTB going for Earthquake. But I know BTB, he's definitely gonna scout. I've been friends with him. I know that he scout for those type of plays. So he's not gonna stay in here. He's gonna go Landorus or Ladi, trying to scout for Scarf T-Bolt. So yeah, if I'm Tricking here, I would definitely go into Landorus, because that covers the opposing Lando, kind of. He does just T-Bolt. So now BTB can either U-turn, get his rocks, or he can also HBIs. HBIs would cover the Hawlucha and the opposing Landorus, and that's like kind of the only thing that Tricking can switch into, because everything else gets destroyed by Earthquake. So Tricking's either gonna go Lucha or Lando. Most likely he's gonna go Lando here. So BTB can HBIs or U-turn, trying to get momentum or trying to get a huge hit off. He does HP Ice, he catches the Lando, that's a 2-hit KO. So now he has the Intimidate on BTB's Lando, so I don't think he's gonna stay in and sack his own Lando. He's gonna switch out exactly. So he goes into Toxapex on another HP Ice. Since it's Intimidated, the Pex is gonna be able to munch the Earthquake, so BTB is most likely gonna U-turn out here. I assume the Pex is gonna go for Toxic or Scald here. Also, I'm a big fan of BTB's team in the sense that it's not really weak to Toxic specs. Toxic Pex is really common at the moment and kind of over-centralizing. Like, the only mod on its team that gets affected by T-specs is Pinsir and Coco. And after Pinsir Mega Evolves, it also doesn't get affected by T-specs. So I assume that he's gonna throw off a Scald or like a Toxic, something like that, if he has Toxic. If he doesn't have it, then he's just gonna Scald. Because there's not really a point in getting up T-specs in this game when it only affects the Coco. Coco also is a really big threat in this game, because like Magnezone is not AV, there's a spike up, and Lando gets murdered by Dazzling Gleam and HP Ice. So Tricking has to predict correct here. If he breaks T-Bolt, he has to go Lando. If he breaks Dazzling Gleam or HP Ice, he has to stay in with his Toxapex. If BTB gets this play correct, he gets put in a super good position. But Tricking stays in, predicting probably predicting a Dazzling Gleam or HP Ice, gets the play correct. BTB is now forced out. Tricking can Toxic or Scald again. BTB's either gonna go Lari or Heatran. I feel like Heatran was like fine as well there, so I'm surprised that he went for Toxic. We do see it was not Black Sludge Toxapex, so it's either most likely Shutshell or Payapa Berry. I already talked about it, he's a bit weak to Volk, so Payapa is an option. So Tricking, if he's Payapa, can go for a Recover. Otherwise, now even if he's not Payapa, I think Psyshock doesn't kill because Lari has his piss weak. So Tricking is just gonna go for a Recover here. And we do see it's a Payapa berry. See, you guys can see it did 30, so it wouldn't have killed without the berry even. So that would have given him information what the Lari locks itself into. And then he could have acted accordingly. So now Tricking can just Scald or Recover again. BTB doesn't want to stay in here because Psyshock, you guys can see, only does like 60. And Tricking can just spam Recover. Tricking could also switch into Sharpedo. So BTB goes on a Heatran. I assume he's going to Magma Storm. He does miss, unfortunately, so he's going to have to take a Scald. I assume it's going to do like 25. It does do 28. So he's just going to Magma Storm again. Tricking does not have good switch-ins at all. And yeah, the Pex is trapped now. BTB is going to Earth Power now. Earth Power 2-hit KOs the Pex. And to be fair, Pex wasn't going to do too much. Like, it only beat the Lari, kind of, because the Lari was toxic. Like, pretty much lost to everything else. Like, I think it could beat the Lando if it gets a burn on that, but other than that, it wasn't gonna put in much work. So now he's either gonna have to go into Sharpedo, Hawlucha, or his own Landorus. The thing is, like I said, Sharpedo sometimes doesn't carry Waterfall, and I'm not sure if a Crunch would kill the Heatran if it's in non-Mega form, because he obviously doesn't want a Mega, he wants to keep his speed boost. Huh. Like, it depends on his moveset and if Crunch kills. If Crunch kills in non-Mega form, then he can definitely go for that. Or if he has Waterfall, he can also go for that. But like I said, I have not seen that on Sharpedo much in OU. But yeah, BTB still has his Coco, still somewhat healthy, and he has his Pinsir. So like, the Hawlucha is not gonna put in much work. And to be fair, BTB doesn't even need his T-turn that much, so it doesn't really matter. I think he's just gonna sack. It goes hard into Landorus, wow. Surprised by that, on the Crunch. So Ice Fang doesn't kill even if he Megas. So unless he's a mixed Sharpedo, BTB can either Ice Fang up and kill the Sharpedo with U-turn. Let me see, why would he keep the... I guess, now the Heatran can take a hit from the Lele still, I guess, that's why he kept it. And if the Lando's defensive, the Heatran also outspeeds the Lando. And can get a Magma Storm off on that. So I guess it makes sense that he kept it, but I don't think it mattered too much. It's Ice Beam, but he forgot to Mega Evolve, wow. So that was either a roll, or BTB is running more Spadef than Tricking things. Then BTB might either be running more Spadef than Standard Lando, or Tricking just messed up and miscalced or something. But yeah, the Sharpedo goes down, there was his potential speed. There was a speed control pretty much, and yeah, it's looking like this game is over in BTB's favor. You can go Pinsir here, right? Yeah, he goes Pinsir. That's what I was thinking, because Pinsir pretty much kind of just wins. Like, that forces him to go Magnezone. Now he can just go Landorus. If he Flash Cannons, that's completely fine. Then he gets a free switch into, like, Heatran or something like that. And if he T-Bolts, amazing for BTB. He can has his Lando in, and then he can click U-turn again or get Rocks up. Yeah, something like that. But yeah, I'm pretty sure BTB is obviously not going to stay in here. he already scouted the first time and Tricking stayed in, so it's most likely Scarf. Magnezone. Yeah, I mean, now that I think a bit about it, I understand why he wanted to keep his Heatran. But yeah, he does just T-Bolt. I mean, Tricking had to kind of hope that BTB chokes and stays in. I can understand why he stayed in. So I assume he's gonna U-turn here. Yep. Lilith can eat that up. So he can go into his... He can go Pinsir again and click Frustration here. Because Psychic Terrain is up, which means Hawlucha can get a speed boost at the moment. But if Pinsir is in, Hawlucha cannot set up. I guess Coco, that works. So he's gonna click Dazzling Gleam here. Because that doesn't get hits everything at this point. There's no need to click T-Bolt when the Lando is still alive. Lando dies from this. I'm pretty sure dies from 50%. Yeah, the game is over. So yeah, he just forfeits. Thank you guys for watching. I think the score is like 1-0 now. But I'm not sure like when this game will go up because my internet is like pretty trash these days. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Hope you all enjoyed. My man BTB is actually 4-0 now in Snake, so it feels super nice. This team has been doing super well. Yeah, I think this was the first game for the series. But yeah, like I said, I might have... Like, I'm planning to record a lot of these games from the series. So I might have already uploaded another game from this series. But yeah, stay tuned for more content. Smash that like button. I'm going to put in more work, get more uploads for you guys. Have a fantastic day and peace out, friends.